The universe is stranger than we think. It's vast, it's expanding, and that expansion is accelerated at a very fast rate. Galaxy mergers are a common occurrence in the universe. It's safe to say that galaxy mergers are among the most fascinating cosmic phenomena. Certainly, supernova and black hole collisions are fascinating phenomena. Galaxy mergers, however, have all that and more. The farthest thing from Earth that can be seen with the naked eye is Andromeda, which is our closest neighboring galaxy. You can only see it if the night sky is very dark and clear. Andromeda is heading towards us and is on a collision track with the Milky Way. But you might not know about this historical event, that it's just a few billion years old. One day, these two galaxies will crash into each other, and when they do, Andromeda and the Milky Way will combine to make a new galaxy. This will change the course of both galaxies for good. What will happen when Andromeda Galaxy completely merges with the Milky Way? And how long do we have before this major cosmic event takes place? Stay to the end to find out all the answers, because we have all of them in this video. So what exactly is the Andromeda Galaxy, and where is it located? One of the few galaxies that can be seen with the naked eye, the Andromeda Galaxy looks like a fuzzy, milky dot. It's around 200,000 light-years across, and 2,480,000 light-years away from Earth, and it shares many features with our own Milky Way. In the year 965, the Islamic astronomer Al-Sufi wrote about it in his book of the fixed stars. The German astronomer Simon Morius found it again in 1612 when he noticed that it looked like a light from a candle seen through a horn. Scientists thought that the Andromeda Galaxy was either part of the Milky Way or a spiral nebula like the Milky Way and other bright gas clouds in the area, which is why it is mistakenly called the Andromeda Nebula. It wasn't until the 1920s that American astronomer Edwin Powell Hubble proved that Andromeda was a separate galaxy from the Milky Way. Andromeda is a lot like our own galaxy, the Milky Way. It has a central bulge of matter, a disk of gas, dust, and stars, and a large halo. Even though Andromeda has about a trillion stars and the Milky Way only has about 250 billion, our galaxy is bigger than Andromeda's because it is thought to have more dark matter. Andromeda will become increasingly visible as it approaches Earth in the future. Even though the two galaxies are still 2.5 million light-years apart, the eventual merger of our two galaxies has, in fact, already begun. Andromeda is currently approaching the Milky Way at a speed of about 70 miles per second. This means that our merger won't happen until 5 billion years from now. But a new, carefully reviewed study that came out in August 2020 issue of the Astrophysical Journal shows the collision between our two galaxies is already happening. Project Amiga Absorption Map of ionized gas in Andromeda, which probes the Andromeda Galaxy's deep space environment with the help of Hubble Space Telescope, is the source of the latest Andromeda Galaxy information. In 4 billion years, according to the estimates of astrophysicists, Andromeda will crash into the Milky Way, and the merger will be complete in 6 billion years. By that time, the Sun will have swollen into a red giant and swallowed up the terrestrial planets, so Earth will have other things to worry about. Galaxy collisions are a normal part of the universe's evolution. In fact, both Andromeda and the Milky Way bear signs of having already crashed into other galaxies. Andromeda boasts a large ring of dust in its center, giving it an interesting shape. Astronomers believe this dust may have formed when it swallowed an existing galaxy. Although the initial phase of the collision of the two galaxies will be quite messy, arms will project wildly from the combined pair. But when the merger is complete, the two galaxies should settle into a smooth elliptical shape. In the past few years, we've learned a lot more about how big the Andromeda Galaxy is. The Andromeda Galaxy, our Milky Way, and other galaxies are all surrounded by a large cloud of gas, dust, and stray stars. This cloud is called a galactic halo. The halos of galaxies are faint, so faint in fact that detecting them is not an easy feat. Astronomers figured out how big the Andromeda Galaxy's halo was by seeing how much light it took in from the quasars in the background. They were surprised to find that Andromeda's galaxy halo stretches far beyond its visible boundaries. Studies done with the Hubble Space Telescope in 2015 show that the Andromeda Galaxy's halo is 6 times bigger and 1,000 times farther than it was before. At the time, astronomers believe the Milky Way might also have a halo, and perhaps the two galaxies' halos are already starting to mix. Then, in 2005 and 2007, the new size estimates were based on watching the stars and how they moved. Even black holes happening in Andromeda were investigated. In late 2017, scientists unexpectedly identified two supermassive black holes closely orbiting each other. At the time, the study team said that the black holes were possibly the most tightly connected of any supermassive ones known. Other discoveries in Andromeda include tracking the birth and death of stars in infrared wavelengths in 2011, finding gamma ray radiation in 2017 that could be signs of dark matter, which is only known by how it affects normal matter like galaxies, and finding a ring of dwarf galaxies around Andromeda in 2013, which could also be found around the Milky Way. NASA announced the merging of the galaxies in 2012. Once Andromeda and the Milky Way collide, a new larger galaxy will form. But unlike its spiral ancestors, this one will be elliptical. Scientists have named the new galaxy that will form as a result of the merger the Milky Way. The Milky Way and Andromeda are the two largest and best-known galaxies in the local group. Andromeda is the most massive member of the local group of galaxies, which would include the Milky Way, the Triangulum Galaxy, and other smaller galaxies. About a dozen satellite galaxies can be found orbiting both Milky Way and the Andromeda Galaxy. Both are some 100,000 light-years across, containing enough mass to make a billion stars. Astronomers used to think that Andromeda was up to 3 times as big as the Milky Way. They thought that our galaxy would be easily pushed aside by its bigger neighbor and absorbed into it. But now the research suggests that we've overestimated our opponent. In a study published in the Monthly Notices by the Royal Astronomical Society, a team of Australian astronomers announced that Andromeda is not actually the heavyweight we once thought it was. Instead, they found our near-galactic neighbor is more or less the same mass as the Milky Way, some 800 billion times the mass of the Sun. We could safely say that the Milky Way is not nearly as overpowered by Andromeda as we once thought. Scientists have known for years that these two galaxies are going to crash into each other, and they've been watching them closely to see how they interact. While the final outcome is still uncertain, researchers expect some dramatic changes when the two galaxies finally meet. There will be a lot of carnage when the two galaxies smash into each other. The new stars will be formed when the Milky Way and Andromeda galaxies collide. On the other hand, many of the stars in both galaxies are quite old and won't make it through the collision. Compression will also cause the interstellar gas and dust to heat up and emit light. Even though there will be a lot of damage, astronomers think the impact will be a stunning sight. The crash will make bright new stars, and the gas and dust that comes will join the Milky Way and Andromeda to make a beautiful new galaxy. When you think about how old the universe is, 4 billion years seems like a pretty long time. Before their collision, the Milky Way and Andromeda galaxies have been orbiting each other for nearly 9 billion years, and they will continue to do so for another 5 billion years after the collision. So in a sense, we will get to see the collision twice. Scientists have a few theories about how the two galaxies might collide. It's possible that they will merge or that Andromeda will pass through the Milky Way. However, it's more likely that they will hit each other head on. The consequence of this collision is still being studied, but scientists believe it could cause massive damage to both galaxies. What do you guys think about the grand collision that will result in a single galaxy? Do let us know your thoughts and comments below. See y'all in the next one.